This morning's reading is from Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 24. This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was pledged to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man and did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us." When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she gave birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
Happy Christmas. Baby Jesus has arrived, and so why don't you choose today to add him to your manger scene? As you open your presents, remember that God's gift to us, wrapped up in Jesus, is that we can be part of his kingdom of goodness and light. Today is a day to celebrate, and even if you can't celebrate in the way that you are used to, remember that Jesus was born in a very unusual place, in a way that hardly anyone would have expected.
But what matters is that he came. And so however else Christmas might have changed this year, we still have a very good reason to be thankful to God and to celebrate. So now your manger scene is complete. How about saying a short prayer together to thank God for the gift of Christmas?
Well, the preparations are over and the countdown has finished. We're now here. It's Christmas Day. A very Merry Christmas to you from wherever you're watching this today. As I was playing with my daughter's nativity set the other day with her, and we were telling the Christmas story, we got to the part in the story where Joseph and Mary couldn't find anywhere to stay in Bethlehem. And so they had to use a stable, or probably more accurately somebody's back garden shed where the animals are kept. And I asked her, "Is this the kind of place you think God's special baby should be born?" And she said, "No, I'm going to go and get my fairy palace." And we carried on the story somehow, talking about where God should be born. But God was indeed born in an animal feeding place, the lowest of the low. And as we reflect with today's carol on that place where God incarnate, God with us, Emmanuel, was born, we think about that hallowed manger, that animal feeding trough, that hallowed manger ground. And that's today's carol, a modern carol that speaks of the beauty and the awe of what God had done in not coming to be born in a palace, but coming to the lowest of the low, to the poor, to those he wanted to reach the most, in the most audacious of ways. And there's a line in that song that says, "What fear we felt in the silent age, where God had spoken in the past through the law that he had given through Moses, through the prophets, in the promise of what was to come. But then in that silent age, what fear we felt until God spoke again with his almighty love letter in the birth of himself, his own son, in the birth of Jesus. And Jesus came to be our redemption. You know, there's these verses in the letter to the Romans that Paul writes. It says, all of creation has been groaning up until this point, as in the pains of childbirth, for our adoption to sonship and our redemption. And it's in this hope that when Jesus came, that we are saved. And that is what we celebrate today. Forget the trimmings and the turkey and all the presents. As nice as they'll be, today we are reflecting, we are giving thanks, and we are looking forward again to Jesus's coming, his return. That's what this Advent season has been all about, as we act out in the rhythm of waiting and longing and yearning, and our souls long to see the day when Jesus will return. So as you celebrate and reflect this Christmas, let's give thanks for our Emmanuel, God with us, as we look for his return too. May God bless you this Christmas day.
What hope we hold this starlit night, a king is born in Bethlehem. Our journey long, we seek the light that leads to the hallowed manger round. What fear we felt in the silent age, 400 years can he be found, but broken by a baby's cry. Rejoice in the hallowed manger ground. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, God incarnate, here to dwell. Emmanuel, Emmanuel, praise his name, Emmanuel. The Son of God, here born to believe, a crown of thorns would pierce his brow, and we beheld this offering, exalted now.
Let's pray together. Eternal God, whatever the road ahead requires, remind me through the stories of old that you can accomplish more than we can perceive or imagine. And though we often struggle to see how this can be, you call us to simply believe. Ever-present God, help me to remember your unending message that whatever else surrounds me, whatever is denied me, and whatever is yet required of me, I am always encircled by your love. Creator God, when I am disturbed and anxious, and the conflicts of this world impose themselves upon me, grant me that inner peace that you promised can defy the darkest human circumstance. Faithful God, when faced with circumstances that are not of my own choosing, and denied those things that cause me delight, grant me the joy of your presence this day, and the contentment of knowing that I am held for all eternity. Amen.